One mistake that almost every homeowner makes, including myself, is I rely on my eyes to visually diagnose what's going on with my yard. And here's what's wrong with that. Almost everything that can be causing an issue in your yard can produce the same visual effects. I'm talking about yellowing grass, browning grass, patches, basically unhealthy grass. While there are a few things that are pretty obviously different, most of the time the visual cues of what's going on in your yard are about the same thing. So while you could go outside and try more fertilizer, less fertilizer, different fertilizer, no fertilizer, weed killer, grub killer, you name it, you go down the list. A lot of times what's easier, cheaper, and quicker is to just find out what's going on down in the soil. So let's get to the root of the issue. See what I did there? And see what's going on with your soil. And the best way to do that is with a soil test. Now there's a few different ways you can test your soil. You can have professionals come and do it and pay a bazillion dollars, but you also can just test your soil yourself. Before I had used a soil test, the idea of testing my soil was a little bit scary. It felt like it was a lot of work. I had to understand what I was talking about. There's pH levels, nitrogen, potassium, blah, 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 blah. Understanding the nutrients that my yard need wasn't something that I was technically interested in. I just wanted green, lush, healthy grass. Well, here's the thing. You don't have to be a soil expert to use a soil test and find out what nutrients to give your soil to get that nice green grass that you're looking for. So today I'm gonna go over exactly how to use an at-home soil test, how easy it can be, and how to use the results of that soil test to get your yard looking exactly the way you want it to be. Number one, pick the at-home soil test. This is one that I've got off Amazon. I've used this for the last couple of years. I'll include a link in the description below for anybody that wants to use the one that I've used, but most of them function about the same way. You collect some soil samples, you send it in, they send you a report. This one's nice because they do also give you some recommendations of fertilizers with nutrients that your soil needs, so they make it really easy from start to finish. One of the things I love about this one by MySoil is it tests for a lot of different nutrients. pH levels, like I said, the acidity, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, that's a NPK ratio that you'll see on most fertilizers. But there's also things like calcium and iron, manganese. And then the last thing, the box gives the directions, okay? You register online, you add your soil, you mail it in, you'll get your results, and then they teach you how to amend the soil and get the right nutrients. And what's even better is you get your results in about a week. To do the MySoil test kit, you're gonna need a couple of things. Number one, obviously your at-home kit. I use the kit from MySoil. You might want some gloves if you don't want your hands to get dirty. And then the other main thing you need is something to collect the dirt. Personally, I love these soil probes. I bought this a couple years ago and I've used this so many times, not only for my soil test, but also I go out every year through the different seasons and I will test my soil to see how much water it's getting. Helps me adjust my sprinklers, make sure I'm not overwatering or underwatering. I have a whole video on that as well, how I use this soil sampler, the soil probe, to check my soil frequently. I do it for my plants, my lawn. Anyways, I use this thing a ton. If you don't have one and you're interested in getting a soil test kit, you might as well do it now. Again, I'll include links in the description below. If you don't have one of these or you're not interested, you can also just use a little hand shovel if you've got one laying around, or you can buy one on Amazon as well for a few bucks. All right, let's open up this test kit and see what's inside. So when you open it up, it is gonna tell you you have to register, so that is something really important. We will go over that in just a second, because what they're gonna do is send you an email after with those results and the recommendations for how to adjust your soil. So they give all the directions right here. You can scan or go to the website, so let's go do that right now. All right, let's register our kits. So the first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna head on over to Google, and you can do this on your phone as well, but it's mysoiltesting.com. All right, we're here. We're gonna register our kit, sign in. If you already have an account, you sign in with your account, otherwise create a new account here. You'll enter your email address, your password. I already have an account, so I will show you what that looks like here. So you can see here, this is one that I did last year, completed. So I'm just gonna register a new kit. Like I said, super easy. You can do this multiple times a year. Register a new kit. So once you get here, you just put in that registration number and you will find that again either on your card right here in the middle, or on that little container. It has that sticker as well with your registration number. You need that number. Do not mail it in without at least taking a picture of that number. I would start by just registering and then you don't have to worry about it, but I'm sure people have sent that in and forgot the registration number and then never got the results. So make sure you have that, enter that here, re-enter it here, put the date that you got the sample.
Description is mostly for you. You could just say backyard or front yard or garden bed. And then your sample type, again, this is where you can tell them what it is. So mine is lawn and turf. And then, yeah, it'll give you some options for square footage. You can say small, medium, large, extra large. Once you've done that, you register the kit and you're good to go.
So now that we're done registering, you can flip this around and you can see some directions on how to do this. And once we've collected the soil, you're gonna put it into the box, the empty box, and we're gonna mix it up. And then we're gonna take a segment of that dirt and put it in the little container that they're giving us that has a solution in it. And that's what we end up mailing back to this company. You can see right here, here's the postage to send it back. And then we've also got, this is the little container that you're gonna put the soil in once we've collected it and mixed it up. This is just the measuring cup you're gonna use to get enough soil to put in here. So this, basically you'll fill up one cup of dirt, put it in here, put it in the packaging, mail it off, check your email, and now you can fix your grass. All right, let's do it. All right, for this test, we're just gonna use my backyard as a testing area. So we're gonna go collect 5 to 7 samples, put it in the empty box. I've just taken the stuff out and set it on the bench back there. So we'll take the 5 to 7, put it in here, and then we'll mix it up. So let's go get those samples. Really quick, just let me show you. So I didn't get a full 6 inches on this one, about 4 inches probably, but when you use a soil probe, all you gotta do to get it out of there is you just get your finger and put it on the bottom end. You can kind of push it up and out, and then you can just grab the whole chunk. My soil's a little bit wet because I watered about 2 hours ago, but now I know my soil is watered correctly. But then you just take it, and then you can just dump it in the box. So I'm at 3, let's go get a few more. All right, I've got my samples. I got 6 because my brain just works that way. Between 5 and 7 is 6. So 6 samples. We're gonna take this back over to the bench, mix these up, and then put them in that little container. All right, now that we have collected the samples, it is time to break up the dirt. So this is the part where you probably want some gloves. What we're gonna do is essentially you wanna take out any of the big plant material. I'm just gonna use this side over here is kind of my throwaway box. So I'm going to take off the tops, get rid of all the bigger plant material. Oh, got me a little worm. Don't want to put him in there. But that's also a sign of healthier soil, so I like seeing that. Now we're ready to get the scoop and scoop up a little bit of this and put it in our little bin. All right, so for this, we're just gonna take our little cup and we're going to take a scoop of this. Like I said, I'm gonna kind of see if there's any other plant material that's easy to get off. And then we're gonna take this, remove the lid. So it says do not, and there's like a little guy right here. So you can know if the seal's been broken. You don't want to remove anything out of here. You're just going to add the soil right into it. Now we're going to put the lid back on and just make sure this thing is tight. All right, look at that. We've got this thing all loaded up. Last thing you're going to want to do though is if you have not registered, please go register at the very least. Go take a picture of whatever your number is and register and get a soil sample. All right, we're heading to the mailbox. Let's do this. Is anybody else's mailbox like a mile away from their house? That was literally the hardest part of this whole video. All right, find the outgoing mail. Oh crap. Gosh dang it. I have to mail it at a real mailbox.
Feels like Christmas morning today because I got my soil test results. So let's go take a look and see what we can find. So if we go here and we log into our dashboard for mysoiltesting.com, you'll get an email that's sent to you that gives you the link. You just log in with your credentials one more time. And you can see it shows me my two different tests that I have done, my one from last year, my one this year. So if I want to click in and see what it looks like, I just click right here. And now it will give me the results of my test. So it's going to give this to you in a couple different formats. This first one is kind of a graph format. So these first three right here are kind of those big three, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, as well as some others like, and you can see over here, here's your kind of your key for it, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. So the S is sulfur. Iron is another big one as far as getting your grass green and lush. Anyways, on down to even your pH level. So you have kind of an optimal level right here. You can see my pH level is actually great, but I am pretty low in some of these nutrients, right? And over here, I like this one better. This gives you kind of that raw soil data for all of them. So you can see right here, my nitrogen, I'm really low. I do have Kentucky bluegrass. It is known to be a nitrogen hog, so I need to up my nitrogen intake on this. I'm good on my phosphorus, which I know can help with disease. But then I also am low on potassium, high on a couple of these, sulfur and calcium. Wow, my calcium is really high. My calcium is really high. I think that's common in clay type soils. Sulfur, I'm not too bad. I'm a little bit high. But then the only other one I'm really kind of interested in is maybe this iron that's pretty low. And so for me, just after a quick look at this, right, I'm going to need a lot of nitrogen. I'm going to need some potassium as well, and then also iron. Those are kind of my three main ones here that I'm looking at probably fixing. Another nice thing that this does as well is this gives you some fertilizer recommendations. Now, a quick warning, they are taking you to their own store where they're going to try and sell you something. I have found that it's a little bit more expensive to just go through them. Again, you're paying for the convenience of, hey, they recommended this to you. It's a smart business model, right? They've got you in, they have the soil test, but you don't need to do that, okay? You could look here to get some ideas for what they're recommending. Then you could go to one of your local home improvement stores or get on Amazon and find something similar that's likely a little bit cheaper. So you can see right here, it gives both an organic and a synthetic option. If I click on the organic, it's going to recommend this one right here, an NPK fertilizer. Again, the P is the phosphorus, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. I'm good on my phosphorus, but I need nitrogen, potassium, right? That's what I saw. I also need some iron. So this one does accomplish my nitrogen and my potassium deficiencies, but it may or may not have the iron. And you may not find everything you need in a single application. I could take something like this that solves nitrogen and my potassium, and then also pair it with Ironite or Iron Pro from Amazon, which is more of an iron supplement to help get that iron boost in there too, if that makes sense. I don't need any pH adjustment, which is nice. There are different ways you can adjust the pH, the acidity in your soil. I'm good. So I'm really looking for a fertilizer that boosts my nitrogen, potassium, and then I'm also looking for an iron supplement as well. So just as an example of taking the information that I found on that My Soil Test recommendation page to find a fertilizer that I think might work better for me, I did go do some research on Amazon, and I found a fertilizer called Neighbor's Envy, which has a nice mix of both nitrogen, potassium, and iron. It also has a couple organic elements like humic and sea kelp, and it also talks about making grass super green. So I'm sure I'll have another video out here soon that maybe reviews how well that this product does. But I'll include links again below to anything that I used on my yard. But again, you're going to want to look at your soil test and see where your deficiencies are, then go find fertilizer adjustments that help you get into that optimal range that soil test gave you.
All right, if you like that video, be sure to like, subscribe, and follow our channel so you'll be notified every time we put out another video. And in the meantime, if you haven't checked your watering, be sure to watch this video right here to find out whether or not you've been underwatering or overwatering your grass. We'll see you on the next video.